Oh my God. WrestleManiac 1130, Blu-ray Maniac 1130. Woo! God, this is my 30,000th time trying to do this video for you guys. I originally was going to do a complete Blu-ray collection, and I didn't want to do that because I have over 800 Blu-rays. And last time I did it, I zoomed through it. I didn't talk about any of the movies. It was a disaster. So I'm deciding to split them up. We've already done my horror movies. We've already done my WWE Blu-rays. Now we're going to go to comedies. There's some DVDs in here only because they're not on Blu-ray yet. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for the constant support that y'all show me. Make me feel like such a special person when I'm really not. I'm almost at 3,500 subscribers. We're about 35 or 40 off maybe when this video uploads. So thank you guys so much. And I'm glad everybody was able to get some extra subs from the shout out video. If you did, you know, it's awesome. With that being said, there's one man that I forgot. I forgot him both times when I did my shout out videos. And he's such a great Blu-tuber. And that is Dean of DVD. If you have not subs to his channel, do it. Don't watch this video. Pause it. Click the description box. Go sub. He's got an outstanding collection. Makes great videos. Speaks really well about the movies. He's very supportive of everybody in the community. He's a great, great, great guy. He's got a great channel. He's close to 1,000 subscribers, so let's get him there. Of all my subscribers that watch these videos, however many of them there are, of my 3,400 and something, I don't know how many of those actually watch. But if you've not subbed to him, go do it. It's worth it, I promise. That being said, my lazy eye, just ignore it. We're going right to it, baby. Y'all ready? Whammy. 21 and over. Hilarious film. A lot funnier than I expected it to be honest with you. Drawing a blank here. Miles Teller was hilarious in this movie. Just a good, you know, raunchy comedy like Harold and Kumar or American Pie or Hangover. It's actually from the guys that wrote Hangover. So yeah, it's 21 and over. It's not like a great film or anything, but it's a funny, raunchy comedy. We got 21 Jump Street, which is a hilarious movie with Jonah Hill and Channing Tatum. Channing Tatum is way funnier than I ever expected him to be. And I just really enjoyed that film. As well as 22 Jump Street. This is the Target exclusive. Steelbook there for you. I'm confused. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, whatever. Yeah, 22 Jump Street. Saw this in the theater with my buddy Matthew. He's actually borrowing the DVD. Well, I pretty much gave him the DVD because I don't ever watch it. But hilarious movie. Next up, we've got 30 Minutes or Less, which is a movie that I just freaking love. It's got Jesse Eisenberg, Danny McBride, Aziz Ansari, Nick Swartzen. It's just freaking hilarious. Danny McBride is so freaking funny in this movie. Especially when they got the 3D glasses on and they're watching Friday the 13th. It just trips me out. But check this out. The Blu-ray's worth getting, like I've said several times, because of the commentary with all these guys on it. It's directed by the same guy that brought you Zombieland and Gangster Squad. 40-Year-Old Virgin, Steve Carell. Kramer loves this movie. Just classic. Just a classic film. Judd Apatow. Production, of course. Just the awkwardness of Steve Carell is just hilarious. Next up, we've got 50 First Dates with Adam Sandler and Drew Barrymore. Really good romantic comedy. Rom-com, as they say in the community, I guess. Basically, she's just, y'all have seen it. She's got short-term memory loss, so she forgets everything every day and has to redo it. And basically, he tries to make her fall in love with him every day. Which is just a corny premise, but I enjoyed it, you know. Sandler doesn't make a lot of great movies anymore to me, and that was one of my favorites from him recently, in the past 5, 6, 7 years. I don't know, it's been longer than that since he made that one, though, probably. 2004, 10 years ago, 11 years ago, Jesus. Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. Let me ask you a few questions. You know, my favorite Jim Carrey movie besides Dumb and Dumber, my second favorite, need to get the sequel, Ace Ventura. It's greatness. We've got Adventures in Babysitting, classic 80s cheese with Elizabeth Shue. It just trips me out because it says it's the 25th anniversary edition and there's no features on it at all. So what exactly does that mean? It means nothing. But, yeah. It's a good movie. Next up, we got the American Pie series. Now, I have all four of these. I've just got two of them I've loaned out to a buddy because he hadn't seen them. Here's American Pie 1 with the slip. And American Pie 2 with the slip. And I've got American Pie. I've got American Wedding and American Reunion. I keep the slips on a lot of mouth. There's the American Wedding. And American Reunion is somewhere in the floor. I don't know where it is. The last two were okay. I love the first two, but the last two were just alright, I guess. Next up, we've got the severely scratched and beaten up Anchorman 1 and 2 steelbook. Anchorman 1 is one of my top 5 movies of all time. It's actually number 4. No, number 5. So yeah. There's that. Ron Burgundy's classic. And then part 2 is just hilarious too. There's 3 versions of it too. There's the theatrical, the unrated, and the extremely long version that's not unrated. It makes no sense, but the unrated one is the way to go. Then you got Armed and Dangerous. Armed and Dangerous. Sorry about that. Full demo there, Chad. Why don't you shut the fuck up and just keep going? Sorry. Rest in peace, John Candy. I love you, brother. Eugene Levy. Speaking of American Pie, there's Eugene Levy. A younger Eugene Levy and Meg Ryan, always looking just extremely boyish, but you know what? It's all good. This movie's hilarious. Armed and Dangerous, dadgum. Another great trilogy here. We've got, yeah, Austin Powers. You got The International Man of Mystery, The Spy Who Shagged Me, and Goldmember, which all three were great films. In order, 1 through 3 is the way I liked them the best as well. Just such great comedies. Another great trilogy is Back to the Future, which I got at McKay's for $34, like almost 2 years ago now, which was good at the time. Now it's been on sale for like $20, you know, here and there. But I just love this trilogy set. Looks it's outstanding on Blu-ray. Just a great, all three movies are great. And then we've got Bad Boys, Martin Lawrence, Will Smith. Of course, Jerry Bruckheimer and Don Simpson production there. Just a great action film. It's got some good comedy in it, too. Where is Bad Boys 2 on Blu-ray? I don't get it. I don't understand. Horrible accent, Chad. Shut the hell up. Bad Santa. This is the new version they've released. It's the unrated version and then the director's cut. Why would those not be the same thing? Usually the director's cut is like more stuff's in it, not less. But either way, great, hilarious movie to watch around Christmas time. Billy Bob Thornton. Then you got John Renner and Bertie Mac in it as well. Rest in peace to both of those fellas. We've got Beetlejuice, Michael Keaton. Classic comedy here with Gina Davis as well as Alec Baldwin. Heard they're making a sequel to this with the rejuvenation of Michael Keaton's career after Birdman, so look forward to seeing that. Then we've got Big with 25th Anniversary Edition. As you can see, this used to sing to you, but now its battery's dead on it, so there's that. My second favorite Tom Hanks comedy, Burbs, is number one. But I love Big, too. I love the Big movie. Then we've got Big Lebowski. Great Coen Brothers film with John Goodman, Jeff Bridges. Steve Buscemi, John Turturro, just such a funny movie. I used to have the Digibook as well, but I sold it because I like this a lot better. And I've got this entire set of steelbooks they put out. As you see, it says The Dude Abides there on the back. A great, great film. My favorite Coen Brothers film. You got Billy Madison. Adam Sandler's greatest movie he's ever done. Second would be Happy Gilmore, I would say. But yeah, just classic. I say classic a lot. Shut up. Black Sheep, not classic, but solid. Chris Farley, David Spade, basically them trying to just relive the Tommy Boy greatness, and not near as good as Tommy Boy, but I still laughed. It still sucks that Chris Farley's gone. We got Blades of Glory with Will Ferrell and John Heder. Kind of a slept on Will Ferrell comedy. They don't really, you never really hear him talk about Blades of Glory. Blades of Glory. They're never going to talk about that movie because it doesn't fucking exist. Blades of Glory. Shout out to my brain scan poster once again. Hilarious movie. Okay. Next up, we got another one of these steel books. They're on a mission from God, and that is the Blues Brothers. Love this steel book. Such a great movie. Very long movie. 2 hours and 28 minutes, the extended version. But I enjoyed it. You know, you got tons of cameos from, like, you know, James Brown, Ray Charles, and others. You got John Belushi and Dan Aykroyd. Just one of the best comedies ever. It's Blues Brothers. And got a John Hughes, one of John Hughes' best films, Breakfast Club. This is the all-new 30th anniversary edition. You know, of course, Emilio Estevez, Molly Ringwald, Anthony Michael Hall, Judd Nelson, Ally Sheedy, John Hughes, another one that died way too young. We could still be getting John Hughes classic films now. He was very young, way too young. It's Breakfast Club. Next up, we've got Bridesmaids, baby. Kristen Wiig, hilarious. Melissa McCarthy, this is the first time I saw Melissa McCarthy. She tripped me the hell out in this movie. She's hilarious. Yeah, Bridesmaids. And we've got Caddyshack, the first one. I also like Caddyshack, too. It's terrible, but it's one of those that I still love. And I just actually picked it up on DVD. That'll be in my next update. But you can't go wrong with this first one. You got Rodney Dangerfield, Bill Murray, Chevy Chase. Freaking hilarious movie. Next, we've got Campaign with Will Ferrell and Zach Galifianakis. This is the extended cut. This movie is... I freaking love this movie. It's so funny. It's just hilarious. Will Ferrell is the greatest, and so Zach Galifianakis is in this movie. The scene at the dinner table when he leaves the answer on the answer machine is one of the funniest things I've ever seen in my life. Another one of these still books. It says it was the last day of school in 1976, a time they never forget, if only they could remember. That is Dazed and Confused, one of the few titles in my collection that I double dip on, just because it's one of my favorites, top 25 for sure. Matthew McConaughey as Wooderson is just greatness. Next up, we've got... Oh, yeah. It's the wrong way. Sorry about this, guys. I've been a little delayed, baby. We right back, though, like we left the car keys. What? Shut up! Don John. The directorial debut of Joseph Gordon-Levitt. A lot of people shit on this movie. I, however, really enjoyed it. Thought it was shot really well. I love Scarlett Johansson. That very much helped this, my thoughts of this movie. And I thought Joseph Gordon-Levitt did a good job directing it. And so, yeah. Next up, we've got Due Date, a classic, not classic, Chad, stop saying that. Robert Downey Jr., Zach Galifianakis, a lot like the classic movie, Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. This one I really, really enjoyed. Nobody really ever talks about it. A lot of people kind of shit on it, saying it was too much like Planes, Trains. But I just loved it. Next up, we've got the two-pack of Dumb and Dumber, which is my favorite comedy of all time. And Jim Carrey's The Mask. Good two-pack there. And we've got Dumb and Dumber 2, which I really enjoyed, and I thought it was going to be terrible. And it very thoroughly surprised me. Nowhere close to the first one. Still liked it. I've watched it 3 or 4 times, and I enjoyed it. We've got Dutch, who is this is a John Hughes production. You got Ethan Randall and Ed O'Neill. Shout out to Minus the Beard. Did Minus the Beard give me this? Or did I get him? No, I got him. Shout out to Minus the Beard anyways. But I think I got him that one time. Anyways, I digress, okay? Dutch. I freaking loved it. I don't remember if I got it off Amazon or if I got it at McKay's. I don't know. Whatever. I love it. Ethan Randall, who was the Rusty from the terrible vacation, Vegas vacation. Anyways, Election. This is Matthew Broderick and Reese Witherspoon. Really, I really enjoyed this one. It was one I never even thought about picking up before. And then my buddy Brian was telling me, man, you need to check it out. And then I, sure enough, I saw it at $7.88 bin at Walmart. So I was like, it's perfect time to get it. And it came with the code as well. So enjoyed that one. Let's check that one out. It's Election. Y'all probably already checked it out. I was late on that one. Then we've got Elf. This is that cool steelbook. Will Ferrell, classic. Stop, Chaz. Stop saying classic. James Caan, Jon Favreau. Film by Jon Favreau, sorry. Will Ferrell is hilarious. Some of these, like I said, are going to be DVDs because they're not on Blu-ray yet, and that is Ernest Saves Christmas. I need to get the other Ernest movies on Blu-ray. I watch this every Christmas. I love it. It's just great, stupid comedy. Can't go wrong with Jim Varney. Rest in peace. He's actually from where around the area I'm from, in White House. We got Fast Times at Ridgemont High with Sean Penn, Jennifer Jason Leigh. Really enjoyed this one. You also got Judge Reinhold in it as well. Sean Penn, just hilarious in this movie. And this is actually a Cameron Crowe in that one. Another one of these awesome steelbooks. If there was a trip to be taken, they were there, and that is Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. Very, very big mindfuck of a movie, but I freaking loved it. Terry Gilliam, same guy that did Zero Theorem, and which is a mindfuck as well. Check that one out. Johnny Depp and Benicio Del Toro. Next, we got another one of my favorite comedies. We got Fletch with Chevy Chase. This is when Chevy Chase was in his prime. I mean, you're talking about this movie, the first two, three vacations. Fletch Lives, I thought was funny. Funny Farm. But I just, he was so quick-witted. It was yet to be duplicated to me. There's Fletch Lives on DVD, obviously, because it's not on Blu-ray yet. Not near as good as the first one, but I still love it. Another one I just freaking love. It's just one of my most ridiculous movies ever, but it's so funny to me. And it's Danny McBride in Foot Fist Way. This is actually produced by Will Ferrell and Adam McKay. It's only on DVD, so he's a karate instructor, if that tells you anything. We've got Forgetting Sarah Marshall. Same guys that brought you 40-Year-Old Virgin, Knocked Up. You know, you have Kristen Bell, Mila Kunis, who I absolutely love, Jason Segel, Russell Brand, who nobody really talks about. Or when they do, they talk about how they hate him. I thought he was really funny in this movie. Jonah Hill's like really creepy character was hilarious too. Then we got a great double feature, Funny Farm and Spies Like Us. Two movies that just tripped me the hell out. Yellow Dog in Funny Farm is the greatest. Like he's just the laziest dog of all time. And Spies Like Us is just great. Chevy Chase, Dan Aykroyd. And where we at? Okay, here we go. Got a triple feature now coming up of Goonies, Gremlins, and Gremlins the New Batch, Gremlins 2. Goonies is one of the greatest movies of all time to me. It's in my top 25. And Gremlins is great. Gremlins 2 is okay, but this is one of the best three packs you can find out there, guys, to me. And another movie that I don't understand why it's not on Blu-ray yet, and that is The Great Outdoors with Dan Aykroyd, John Candy. Just watched this a couple of weeks ago. Freaking just still love it. The whole scene when he's at the restaurant trying to eat the 96 ounce steak, it's just hilarious. And we've got Bill Murray and Andy McDowell in Groundhog Day, a movie that 15th anniversary edition. This was back in 2008, I think, when this came out. Yeah, so just hilarious movie. Bill Murray's the man. I got another Blu-ray double feature of Hall Pass, the enlarged edition, and Wedding Crashers. Hall Pass was good. It wasn't great. I think it's funny. I don't think it's hilarious. I think Jason Sudeikis is hilarious. I'm not a big Owen Wilson fan. However, in Wedding Crashers, he was great. And Vince Vaughn is great. Wedding Crashers is another one of the greatest comedies. And you got Christopher Walken in there, too, plus a little Will Ferrell action. Now we got the Hangover Trilogy. We got Hangover Part 1. Got Hangover Part 2. and Hangover Part 3. Notice a lot of these don't have slips because I sold a lot of them just because slip covers I'm not near as big on as I used to be. I keep the ones that I really, really like, but I'd rather help you guys out that like them more than me, and that's why I sold a lot of my slips. The trilogy is great. You know, the first one obviously is one of the greatest comedies of the last 10 years. Two wasn't all that good. It was basically a rehash of one. Three was better than two, I thought, but either way, this is going to be a feat because these are just stacked. Sorry for the long video, but this is just my comedies. We're already at 20 minutes halfway through. Happy Gilmore, Adam Sandler, second best Adam Sandler movie. And then I think Big Daddy would probably be three. And that's like the order they came out to. But I still die laughing at him and Shooter McGavin going back and forth. We've got The Heat with Melissa McCarthy and Sandra Bullock. This movie makes me laugh out loud every time I watch it. I've watched it 6-7 times since I bought it. And it just, Melissa McCarthy is so ridiculous in this movie, but it's hilarious to me. I wish they would do another one. We've got Heavyweights. Just childhood favorite to me. I'm trying to say classic because Kramer loves it. And it trips me out because Ben Stiller's character in this movie is the same character he plays in Dodgeball. Y'all know what I'm talking about if you've seen this. Heavyweights is just great. I mean, I love the fact that it's on Blu-ray. And it's got great special features. It's got like a Where Are They Now of all the guys and stuff. Just love that movie. We've got the Home Alone 2-pack of Home Alone and Home Alone 2 Lost in New York. The only two Home Alones worth getting. The other three or four are garbage. It's none of the same people, obviously. But y'all know how great those are. Must-watch movies during Christmas time. Next up, we've got Horrible Bosses. Freaking love this movie. You got Jason Bateman, Charlie Day, who's turned out to be one of my favorite comedic actors right now. I'm finally in Always Sunny, and he's just hilarious in that. You got Jason Sudeikis, Jennifer Aniston, who's my second favorite celebrity of all time. Elaine Bennis is number one. Laugh if you want. I don't give a fuck. She's my favorite. Jennifer Aniston's right behind her, and I'd like to get behind. Anyway, Chad, stop. Colin Farrell, Kevin Spacey, Jamie Foxx. Y'all know how funny this movie is. And then here's one that everybody shit on, said it wasn't funny. I thought it was funny. That's Horrible Bosses 2. I thought it was really funny. I mean, it's not the good of the first one, but it's not supposed to be. We've got Hot Rod. This is what introduced me to Danny McBride. And what better way? I like to party. That's all I'm going to say. Next up, we've got Hot Tub Time Machine Part 1. John Cusack, Rob Corddry, who's hilarious. Craig Robinson and Clark Duke. Freaking love this movie, the first one. The second one is good, too. A lot of people shit on it as well. You don't get John Cusack except for at the very end, but Adam Scott's funny. He's just not as funny as Cusack was, but I still enjoy that one as well. Oh, me. It's going to have to be broken into... I don't know. We're going to find out what happens. Next up, we've got... almost a spill. Identity Thief, Jason Bateman, Melissa McCarthy, hilarious. The part where he's like trying to chase her on the interstate is just, so that would be me if it was me running from somebody. I Love You, Man. Slap of the Bass. Freaking love this movie. Paul Rudd is so great at being awkward. He's like the most funny, awkward person I've ever seen. Jason Segel's great. And what's her name? I love her too. Rashida Jones. She's beautiful. We got a really good 3-pack here of The Internship, The Watch, and Dodgeball. Obviously, Dodgeball is the greatest one of these three. Internship was okay. Just didn't really like it. The premise was kind of dumb, but it was okay. The Watch I thought was funny. The premise was ridiculous in The Watch, but I thought it was hilarious. Ben Stiller, Vince Vaughn, Jonah Hill, and I'm not even going to try to pronounce that guy's name. Got The Interview with James Franco, Seth Rogen. A lot of people shit on this movie. I think Seth Rogen was okay in it. He was kind of annoying in this one. James Franco, though, made this movie to me. He was the funniest thing about this movie. They hate us because they ain't us. Okay? We've got Just Go With It, one of the few Adam Sandler movies from recent times that I really enjoyed. Another one that I have Blended. It's loaned out to somebody. I didn't forget to show that one, but I have that one. That one and this one are about the only two of his last five or six movies that I thought was any count. I didn't really like Grown Ups. I had one and two, and I sold those. I just didn't like them. I thought they could have been way funnier. But Just Go With It was good, and it's got my boo in it, Jennifer Aniston. And Brooklyn Decker, Jesus Christ. Just One of the Guys, DVD, one of my favorite 80s comedies with Joyce Heiser and Billy Jacoby, who is also in Cujo. He's the best part about this movie, and the fact that she gets topless at the end, but hilarious movie. Good, just raunchy, Revenge of the Nerds type comedy. We've got Kindergarten Cop with Arnold Schwarzenegger. It's Not a Tumor. Just ridiculous action drama. Y'all know how good that movie is. We've got Kingpin with Woody Harrelson, Randy Quaid, Bill Murray, and Vanessa Angel. Bill Murray is the best part of this movie. We got Knocked Up with Seth Rogen. Classic. Yes, I said it again. Classic. Just hilarious. Y'all know how funny that is. That's when they really started getting the ball rolling with those Apatow films. And you got Liar Liar, Jim Carrey. Probably my third favorite Jim Carrey film. Sorry. I love when he was beating himself up. I just thought that was funny. Next up, we've got Like Father, Like Son, which I just watched. Me and my buddy Brian watched this weekend. So just hilarious, ridiculous premise, obviously. But this one and Vice Versa both came out around the same time. They're both hilarious. This is the one with Dudley Moore and Kirk Cameron. Kirk Cameron just sucks at life. But Dudley Moore is great in this movie. We've got License to Drive, another one of my favorite comedies from the 80s, starring the Feld doll, Corey Feldman, Corey Haim, and then you got Heather Graham. And you got Billy Ocean on the soundtrack, so can't go wrong there. Another Corey Haim film, Lucas, with Corey Haim, Charlie Sheen, Cary Grant, Winona Ryder. This could actually be considered drama, too, but I put it in comedy because it's got some comedy elements, too. But such a great movie. Then we've got one of the worst movies I've ever seen in my life, but I'll never sell it, and that's Manborg. Just look it up. I can't even get into how terrible this movie is, but it's terribly amazing. Got Me, Myself, and Irene. Just picked this up recently at that sale that we had at work. Solid Jim Carrey movie, not great. Went back and rewatched it. It was okay. It wasn't great. Then we've got three of my movies from Tom Hanks that should have a Blu-ray release in the U.S. I know there's a few U.K. releases of The Burbs, but this is a Tom Hanks three-pack of Money Pit, Burbs, and Dragnet. I've watched Burbs like 10 times in the last 2 years since I bought this. Dragnet's great. So is Money Pit, but just three awesome movies. I wish Tom Hanks would do comedies again. Kramer agrees. And we've got My Cousin Vinny, Joe Pesci, Ralph Macchio, Marissa Tomei. Just a great movie, you know. But watching Joe Pesci as a lawyer is just funny in itself. And we've got the Napoleon Dynamite 10th Anniversary Edition. Y'all know how great that movie is. That's a love it or hate it movie, though. You either love Napoleon Dynamite or you can't freaking stand it. Next up, we've got Chevy Chase and National Lampoon's Vacation. One of the best comedies of all time, bar none. I don't care what anybody says. I do not want to see the remake. I don't give a shit about Ed Helms trying to be Rusty Griswold. I don't. I'm sorry. I've watched several trailers. I've refused to. I don't want to watch that. You do not need to remake that. I'm going to rant. Stop chat. National Lampoon's European Vacation, another one that I just freaking love. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, my favorite Christmas film of all time. And I don't have Vegas Vacation because it's god-awful. Next up, we got Neighbors, Seth Rogen, Zac Efron. Really enjoyed this one as well. Zac Efron surprised me with how funny he was. And James Franco's brother, Dave Franco. Plus, you got McLovin in this as well. He does a great De Niro impression, by the way. Just random thought, but he does in the movie, and it's funny. Next up, we've got Next Friday. I have Friday as well somewhere. I don't know where it is, but I have it. But here's Next Friday. Day-Day, Mike Epps, hilarious. Got Nick and Nora's Infinite Playlist. This is like a drama and a comedy. I just put it in comedy. because Michael Cera made me laugh the entire movie. And Kat Dennings is really hot. So, got Old School, Will Ferrell, Luke Wilson, Vince Vaughn. Y'all know how great that movie is. We're going streaking. Another great Will Ferrell movie, The Other Guys, Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg. I'm interested to see this new movie that they're coming out with, too. I think one of them's the stepdad and one of them's the dad or something. I don't know. It looked pretty funny from the trailer I saw. I'm sure I'll enjoy it as Will Ferrell. Got Our Idiot Brother, Paul Rudd, Elizabeth Banks, Zooey Deschanel, and Emily Mortimer. Paul Rudd's in my top five comedic actors ever. He's just so funny. And Willie Nelson, look at his dog. Looks like Kramer, kind of. We've got a great 80s comedy with Overboard, one of the cheesiest covers ever made. Goldie Hawn, Kurt Russell. Goldie Hawn's hot. Well, she was then. I don't know about now. But Pee-wee's Big Adventure. I do not have Big Top Pee-wee. It was god-awful. This is just a great, great movie from back in the day. And he's getting a new movie straight to Netflix, which is going to be interesting. I think it's like a Christmas movie. And they showed him in costume, and he looked the exact same. I don't know how that's possible, but... You got Pineapple Express, Seth Rogen, James Franco yet again. Just hilarious movie. This is one I wish they'd do a sequel to, but I guess they won't. You got Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. I wish I could have that lenticular slip for this one. Steve Martin and John Candy, a John Hughes classic. One of my favorite comedies ever. Also, make you tear up, too. So, and the last movie I'm going to show on this, it's going to shoot to another clip in just a second. It's my Police Academy Complete Collection. Of all seven films, you've got Police Academy, Police Academy 2, First Assignment, Police Academy 3, Back in Training, Police Academy 4, Citizens on Patrol, which is my favorite one, even though it's terrible, Police Academy 5, Assignment Miami Beach, and the last two, which are god-awful, City Under Siege and Mission to Moscow. This is a UK edition, but they're region-free. Just must-own comedies to me. I'll be right back. We're back, guys. Sorry about that. All right, left off with Police Academy. Next up, we've got Raising Arizona. Coen Brothers film, thought it was really, really good. Nicolas Cage, Holly Hunter, just watched it a couple of weeks ago for the first time. Enjoyed it. Revenge of the Nerds, another one of my favorite comedies from the 80s. I can't wait till part two is on DVD, or Blu-ray, I'm sorry. Yeah. Robert Carradine's hilarious. So is Booger. Got Role Models, that is actually directed by, I forgot his name, David Wayne, who's the same guy that directed Wet Hot American Summer, which I just watched. I thought that was a very odd movie, but I thought it was funny in parts. He also did Wanderlust, which I freaking love. This is Paul Rudd, Sean William Scott, and Christopher Mintz-Plasse, you know, McLovin. I thought that was a funny film. We got a must-own comedy, 20th anniversary of The Sandlot, with that baseball slip there. You're killing me, Smalls. Another one of these steelbooks, an epic of epicness. Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Really enjoy that film. Look, I love the way it's shot. Just a good movie. We got Semi-Pro Will Ferrell. Nobody really likes this movie of his. I thought it was really funny. But I'm biased because I'm a big Will Ferrell fan. So, yep. And we've got Sex Tape, which nobody liked but me, apparently. Nobody. Nobody liked it. Cameron Diaz, Jason Segel, Jack Black has an epic cameo in this as well. I don't really recommend that because not everybody hates it, but I enjoyed it. We got 16 Candles with Molly Ringwald and Anthony Michael Hall, another one that I really enjoyed. Romantic comedy. One of the best ones that they ever did. Next up, we've got the 28th anniversary steelbook of Spaceballs. It's a freaking beautiful steelbook. Looks great on Blu-ray. Such a funny Mel Brooks film with Mel Brooks, John Candy, Rick Moranis, Bill Pullman. Just hilarious. Hilarious movie. Oh, freak. And I left three out from way before. So we're going to just throw these in real quick. Funny People with Adam Sandler. Seth Rogen and Leslie Mann. I enjoyed this one. Now, this was a very long movie for a comedy, but I enjoyed it. A lot of people didn't. We've got Get Him to the Greek with Russell Brand and Jonah Hill, which is a lot like a sequel to Forgetting Sarah Marshall to me, but I thought it was hilarious. P. Diddy was really funny in it as well. Then we got the Ghostbusters 1 and 2 Digibook. These look amazing on Blu-ray, and they're such great movies. I refuse to see the all-female version. Okay, so sorry. Kramer doesn't want to see it either. Next up, we've got my second favorite comedy of all time, Step Brothers. Will Ferrell, John C. Reilly. Freaking love this movie. I freaking love it. Okay? Freaking love it. We got Stripes, that Pop Art Steelbook with John Candy and Bill Murray. Great 80s comedy. Nobody ever talks about it, but I thought it was awesome. And we've got Superbad. You see the poster for it there? One of my favorite comedies ever. Seth Rogen. Not Seth. Yeah, Seth Rogen's in it. Jonah Hill, Christopher Mintz-Plasse, and Michael Cera. It's one of the raunchiest verbal movies ever, but I loved it. We've got Super Troopers, Broken Lizard, you know, film. I love this movie. It's so funny, especially when Farva goes to order a large soda. We got Talladega Nights, another great Will Ferrell movie with John C. Reilly. Ricky Bobby. Chatty Bobby. Why do you think I got influenced? It's Ricky Bobby, daggummit. Tammy, everybody hated this movie. I didn't hate it, but I didn't think it was that great. But I'm going to give it a second watch sometime. But yeah. I just didn't know if it wanted to be a comedy or a drama to me. It was kind of back and forth. We've got Ted with Mark Wahlberg, Mila Kunis, and Seth MacFarlane as the voice of Ted. I love this one. Now, the second one I don't think looks funny at all, but I'm sure it will be. But the previews don't do it any justice. But I knew they were going to milk it and keep making them. We've got Teen Wolf, one of my favorite comedies ever, in my top 25. Which sounds ridiculous, but I don't care. You can put whatever you want in your top 25, and that's going to be in mine. Michael J. Fox, awesome. It's a werewolf that plays basketball. Are you serious? This is 40, which is a sort of sequel to Knocked Up. Paul Rudd is freaking hilarious in this movie. Leslie Mann's great. Shut the fuck up, Kramer. Just playing. I love Kramer, but he never stops barking. This is the end. James Franco, Jonah Hill, Seth Rogen, Jay Baruchel, Danny McBride, Craig Robinson, Michael Cera, Emma Watson. Freaking hilarious. The first 10 minutes, just I was rolling. I may actually watch that tonight. Just freaking love that movie. Three Amigos, another great movie. Steve Martin, Chevy Chase, Martin Short. Another one when Chevy Chase was just hilarious. Throw Mama from the Train, Danny DeVito, who was the best part about Always Sunny, besides Charlie Day. Billy Crystal. Ann Landers, I think's her name. Or Ann. No, that's not right. Ann Ramsey. Sorry. Ann Randall. Anyways, chat. I thought that was really funny, though. We've got Tommy Boy. Classic comedy with David Spade and Chris Farley. Again, rest in peace, Farley. That movie's so great. Another one of my favorite comedies from the 80s. You got John Hughes, once again, directing a great comedy with Uncle Buck, starring John Candy. I don't even want to begin to rant about this whole Mike Epps being Uncle Buck in some new television series. That sounds like the biggest piece of shit I've ever heard in my life. Why call it Uncle Buck for? Makes no sense. And I love Mike Epps, but that's so stupid. Van Wilder, sorry for the rant. Ryan Reynolds, Tara Reid is good, raunchy comedy. It's cheap, it's like $5 at Target. Walk Hard, Dewey Cox story. Freaking love this movie. And the unrated version is more hilarious than the other one I have. Wonderlust, another movie directed by David Wayne. Paul Judd, oh my God. Paul Rudd, Jennifer Aniston. I was distracted looking at Jennifer Aniston on the cover of this. The scene where Paul Rudd is trying to psych himself up to get with that chick when he's talking dirty to himself in the mirror. One of the funniest scenes I've ever seen in a movie, ever. Got Wayne's World, classic Mike Myers film. I need to get part two. Swing, swing, swing. Okay. Wedding Singer, another really good Adam Sandler movie. I would probably say this is my third favorite, and Big Daddy would be after that. Him and Drew Barrymore have really good chemistry. That movie's just great. Weekend at Bernie's, another one of my favorite 80s comedies with Jonathan Silverman, Andrew McCarthy, and Terry Kaiser as Bernie, who did an amazing job at playing a dead guy the whole movie. Part two's great. Not great. Part two's good, too. It'll never probably make a Blu-ray release, though. We're the Millers, extended cut, with my boo again, Jennifer Aniston, Jason Sudeikis, and I forgot dude's name, Will Poulter, who's supposed to be Pennywise in the new It, and then I heard it got canceled. They canceled the whole idea. No reason, no idea why they would make him It. It makes no sense. I don't understand. Shut up, Chad. Weird Science, Anthony Michael Hall, Island Michael Mitchell Smith, who I never saw in anything after this, Kelly LeBrock, John Hughes, once again, just a great 80s cheese fest there. Got White Men Can't Jump with Woody Harrelson and Wesley Snipes, as well as Rosie Perez. Just freaking love that movie. Then we've got The Best of Saturday Night Live, Will Ferrell, Volume 1. I've watched this so many times, it got so scratched I had to take it to get it buffed up so I could watch it, you know, so I could keep watching it because it's so funny. I need to get Volume 2 as well. And then we've got the Mel Brooks classic, Young Frankenstein. That's that cool steelbook. Freaking love this movie. If y'all haven't seen it, check it out. Yeah. You got, Gene Wilder. So great in that movie. And then we've got Your Highness, starring Danny McBride, James Franco, Natalie Portman. Everybody shits on this movie, says it sucks. I thought it was funny as fuck. Danny McBride just cracks me up. So does James Franco. And it's also got Zooey Deschanel in it. And last but not least, we've got Zach and Miri Make a Porno with Seth Rogen, Elizabeth Banks, Craig Robinson, Jay from Jay and Silent Bob. You got a cameo from a couple of porn stars, apparently. Katie Morgan and Tracy Lords. Kevin Smith film. I thought it was awesome. Not a big fan of Clerks. Not a big fan of Mallrats. I thought I would be. I just wasn't. I need to give him another watch. I don't have Clerks anymore. I sold it. But Mallrats, I think I've got it somewhere around here. But, yep. Zach and Mary Make a Porno. Freaking loved it. And that is the comedies. So, stay tuned. The next we'll upload will be my action films. And you want to talk about a cheese fest? Prepare yourselves, guys. Comment below on some comedies that y'all think I should get to my collection. Tell me what you thought of mine. And I love each and every one of y'all. Be sure to subscribe to my boy Dean of DVD below, baby. Lil P. Hellgree. Woo!